Nissan has updated the adorable Kicks crossover for 2021, and the quality of life improvements are rather substantial. So today, let's take a look at what this little guy has to offer. The first big update here is in the aesthetics department. Look at the front end of Kicks. It now sports the much more aggressive shield-like front grille that the brand is rolling out into all of its crossovers and SUVs. And that's thanks to this new bumper design, which in general is rather handsome and actually flows quite nicely into these full LED headlights, which are really slick in this segment. The Monarch Orange metallic paintwork is contrasted with these blacked out 17-inch wheels, which look quite handsome. And I also like the inclusion of these roof bars here, which means you can absolutely load up a few snowboards here for a weekend getaway to Big Bear. The funky styling continues out back. Again, I love this two-tone blacked out roof with the orange paint. Then there are smaller details. Like, I love this aggressive curvature that rolls into this light bar, which looks really interesting in my opinion. It really catches your eye. Something else that also catches my eye in a bit more of a problematic way is down here. This chrome exhaust finisher is an option you'll pay a couple hundred bucks for, and it sticks out very far and you will absolutely knock your shin into it while walking around the car, which is very annoying. Man, everything about this car really is just the cutest, even down to this teeny tiny little prop rod. But jokes aside, the Kicks only has one powertrain combination available here. It's a 1.6 liter inline four, good for 122 horse and 114 pound-feet of torque, which is sent to the front wheels only via continuously variable automatic transmission. EPA fuel economy figures, though, are promising, because while this may not be powerful, it certainly is fuel efficient. It returns figures of 31 mpg city, 36 mpg freeway, and 33 mpg combined. Inside, this SR trim Kicks is pretty nicely equipped. We have Primatex synthetic leather seats, which look quite nice in this gray and contrast orange stitching to match the exterior. Then we have features like Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, which are now standard for 2021. Along with, because it has the optional premium package, features like Bose audio, which is actually integrated into the driver's seat right here, which is a cool touch. Then you have things like heated seats and a heated steering wheel and Wi-Fi hotspot connectivity. And I think overall, Nissan's done a good job here dressing up what is otherwise a subcompact crossover with a 20 grand base price. Because sure, there are a lot of cheap, kind of scratchy plastics, but a lot of the touch points are pretty nice overall. Another cool feature is an available interior lighting package, which if you push a little button down here, can actually change the footwell lighting to 20 different colors at night, which is again, very cute. I wanna point out a few more things while I'm up here in the front of the Kicks is, first of all, look how much space I actually have in this vehicle. Now sure, this thing has an absolutely tiny footprint on the road, but at 6'1", look how much headroom I actually have in this little car. That's fantastic. And beyond that, let's talk about some more practical things. Down here, we have a few plugs to play with, a USB-C, a USB, and a 12-volt outlet, which is quite nice. But one of the more interesting things that I caught on to is actually the backup camera in this vehicle. I wanna single this out because this is one of the few vehicles in this sort of inexpensive sub-crossover segment to actually feature a surround view camera system, which is really nice. While most of the action in the Kicks is obviously in the front row, let's talk about what's happening back here in the second row. Most crucially of which is that I fit back here. Again, I'm 6'1", and with the driver's seat in my position, I have about an inch of knee room. I just barely fit down here, and about an inch of headroom, so I just barely fit up here. But I do still fit, which is quite nice, because again, this vehicle is quite small overall. Beyond that, there's not a ton to talk about back here, as you might expect for most vehicles in this segment. There are two charging points down here. They're USB, but that's about it. Kind of like the second row in the Kicks, trunk space is not exactly cavernous, though it does have quite a good amount of depth and height to it, which is quite nice, making the aperture very easy to get into and out of. Worth pointing out is that while the second row seats do fold down, they absolutely do not fold down flat, because for whatever reason, the second row seats are elevated quite a ways above the false floor here. Now, you'll have to excuse how hard the Kicks little 1.6 liter engine is working, because we are going up a hill. Though I suppose that it's indicative of something you may run into in the real world. Once you load yourself and your friends and some gear into this thing for the weekend getaway, this little engine has to work really, really hard, especially at freeway speeds. Now, around town, the acceleration and performance is absolutely fine. It's adequate. However, again, once you're kind of going at a higher speed or up a hill, you really do realize just how small of an engine is moving a vehicle of this size. Mercifully though, the Kicks is a smooth operator overall. The ride is definitely tuned for comfort and it shows. This road's rather bumpy, but you probably can't tell on the camera. And it just rides quite nice overall. And when you aren't going up a big steep hill and the engine isn't working quite as hard, it's a pretty refined unit. It's pretty smooth. Though part of that is definitely thanks to the continuously variable automatic transmission, which kind of does its best to kind of keep the engine in the meat of a power band. Now, despite the incredibly meager powertrain, there's something about the Kicks I just find to be very, very charming. Maybe it's the cutesy aesthetic, or maybe it's just the fact that I do appreciate a bit of cheap and cheerful motoring. Not to call the Kicks cheap when you have a base price of 20 grand for a crossover. Well, it is a kind of inexpensive vehicle, and I find that just, in a way, honest and kind of refreshing and charming. Though, I would be remiss if I didn't say that this is the least powerful vehicle in the segment by quite a substantial amount. You know, you look at any of the smaller subcompact crossovers, like the Mazda CX-3, and maybe like the Honda HR-V or Toyota CHR, and all those vehicles have like a 20 plus horsepower average over the Kicks. And 20 plus horsepower, when this thing only has 120 to begin with, is substantial in the real world. Though the trade-off is definitely in the fuel economy, because compared to pretty much any vehicle in this segment, the Kicks is one of the more fuel-efficient vehicles. The Kicks is helped, however, by its very modest base price. You can hop into a Kicks for just over 20 grand for a base model, though this basically loaded test car is 27 grand. And that does make it very, very competitive in this segment, because any of the other options out there are pretty much going to start around 22 grand for comparison. And I should note that a lot of the options on this particular test vehicle are more demonstrative of what you can do rather than what you should add to the base price. A really nice Kicks will set you back about 24 grand. A definite strong suit for Kicks are the included driver aids, of which there are many. This thing has features like blind spot monitoring, lane departure warning, intelligent cruise control, and the list goes on. And in a vehicle of this size and that price point, that is very, very nice. Though it is worth pointing out that a lot of the competition, like the Honda HR-V and Toyota CHR, also do have their respective suite of driver and safety aids. I think a big part of the appeal of Kicks, in addition to the low base price, is just the attractive styling. It's a very funky and fun to look at car, but it's not quite as outlandish as something like the Toyota CHR, nor kind of as boring as the Honda HR-V. It does strike this nice balance of being a fun to look at, attractive vehicle that you'd be happy to have parked in your driveway. And the fact of the matter is, while it may be quite slow in terms of acceleration, in the real world, you don't care about that. No one's doing 0-60 runs in their Nissan Kicks. Instead, you'll be focused on the fact you're getting 30 plus miles to the gallon in a cool little car that you can drive every day, and maybe throw your gear on the roof rack and do a fun weekend getaway with it. So if you're interested in a funky, well-styled, inexpensive subcompact crossover that has a bit of spunk bumper behind the wheel, you should check out the Nissan Kicks. Or if any of the competition has piqued your interest as well, you can learn more about them by going to the link in the description down below or going to autobytel.com.